Sometimes we have to increase the value of capacitor, but we have capacitor of small capacitance. We want to change the values and we want to use a bigger value capacitors. Sometimes the capacitor gives a potential difference for what it is designed. But in our circuit, what we need is a higher potential difference. And sometimes we want to store more charges, more energy than designed for a capacitor. In all such cases, we have to combine more than one capacitors. There are different designs of combinations, and according to those designs, we get the output. Sometimes capacitance is increased, sometimes charge is increased, and in this way, we can change the combinations. So, now we will study how we can combine more than one capacitors and what is the effect of those combinations. So, basically, we can combine the capacitors in two manners. One is, there is one capacitor with plate A, B. There is another capacitor with plate C and D. And when we want to give charge to them, we have to connect them with a charge giving energy source, that is battery. Because we are referring battery for the first time, I would like to tell you that we will use this sign for source of energy, and that is battery. From one plate, this will give negative charges, electrons, and this is positive charges. And there is a potential difference between the two plates. We will call it a cell. Combination of cells make it a battery, and what we get are two terminals, and two terminals are shown like this. This is positive terminal, this is negative terminal. There is potential difference between the two plates. Whenever we connect it with a capacitor, then one plate is connected with positive plate, one is connected with negative plate, and then the electrons from this side are gathered here, and this positive pulls electron from this plate, so this becomes positively charged. This capacitor is now charged. This is the method how we charge a capacitor. Okay, this is charging. For some times, electrons are flowing from here to here. At the same time, electrons are flowing from here to here. But when this goes on, then after some time, we find it stops. Why? Because it has reached the maximum of charges, and the maximum charges are capacitance C multiplied by V. What is this V? V is the potential difference. This is connected with this, this is connected with this. So the maximum potential difference developed here is V, and C is the capacity, which we know is controlled by dimensions. So this much charge is collected on this. This is how a capacitor is charged. Okay. Now, charging. How do we discharge? Discharging. So, discharging, this is capacitor, positive, negative charges. We connect these two, and this, the moment we connect it, all these electrons will jump and come to positive because of attraction. And this is no passage, this is air or dielectric, which will not allow electrons to pass. So electron will come here and neutralize these positive charges. This will become zero, and this will also become zero. And what has happened? Discharging. This is charging of a capacitor, this is discharging of a capacitor. Okay, now this we will keep on using at different occasions. These are the two capacitors and we want to combine them, there are two methods to combine them. One is this, this is AB and this is CD. B is connected with C, one plate, and then we put battery here. So when the charges, let us say the positive charges go from here, they go up to this place. Now this is battery is positive and this is negative. If I want to go from plus to minus, what is the path I have? I have to pass through this capacitor. Then there is no shortcut coming to minus. I also have to pass this capacitor. Then only I can come to minus. So in a path from between the two points, I will say let this point be P and this point be Q. If from P I want to go to Q, I have to jump it as well as I have to jump it. So how many capacitors or as many capacitors on the way I have to cross, all those are supposed to be connected in series. This word we must remember, that these capacitors are in series between P and Q. Between P and Q. So between any two points, the capacitor are supposed to be in series. When going from one point to the other point, we have to pass through every capacitor. Now, this is series connection. Now again, there are two points. One is P and this one is Q. This capacitor C1. This is another capacitor C2. Between P, Q, I want to go from P to Q. This is the path I go from here, jump one capacitor, reach Q. Okay, I have jumped only one. Now again I go from P to Q, go here, jump capacitor C2 and reach Q. So from P to Q there are two paths and these two are parallel paths, just like two banks of a river, parallel path, and in one path I have to pass through one only, not two, and here again one only, not two, and there are two parallel paths. So these two are connected to each other and this connection is known as parallel connection. Parallel. So this is series. In series you will find that one plate of one capacitor is connected with one plate of the other capacitor. The second one are not connected together. I can omit this. Okay. This way. So from P to Q there is a path, cross this, so these are in series. From P to Q there is only one in one path, there is only one in the other path. This plate is connected through a conductor with this, this plate is connected through a conductor with this. Both are connected with both. Here one is connected with one, other is not connected with the other one. So this is parallel, this is series. So this is the difference. These are the two type of combinations of capacitors. Sometimes we make a wider net and it may be like this. You will say it is series. Now here is point A, here is point B, and this C3, this is C1, C2. So here C1 and C2 between A and B are in series, but C3 is not in series because when we go from A to B, does not come in the way. Similarly, one very important thing I would like to tell, if A to B we are going through C3, A to B we are going through this, then C1 and C3 are parallel, not. Why they are not parallel? Because when we go from A to B, after crossing C1, we have not reached B. After crossing C3, we reach B. But after crossing C1, we have not reached 3. We have to cross this also. Then only we reach B. So these two are in series, but this whole combination is parallel to C3. That is C1 plus C2. This combo, is parallel to C3. This is parallel to C3. So this type is known as mixed combination. So mixed combination is not a new combination. This is a combination of series and parallel. This is pure series because all capacitor we have to cross once, and there may be so many like this. All this C1, C2, C3, C4 are in series. And here we can have more like this. So C1, C2, C3. All one plate is connected with P, and other plate of all the three are connected with Q. So all three will be known as in parallel. But here C1 is not parallel with C3 because this plate is not connected with this. Had these two been connected, then these two are in parallel. If these are not connected, it is not parallel. This alone, one plate is connected on this side, but the other plate is not connected here. So these two are also not parallel. But if we make a combo of these two combination, then this combination is in parallel to C3. So this is all about how we declare that two capacitors are in series and two capacitors are in parallel. So in the next lecture, we take them individually and find out which are the characteristics, which are combined, how they are combined, what increases, what decreases, and other formulas. Thank you.